the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. This is a memorial mass honoring the death and the entrance into heaven of the mother of our first priest, Father Augustus Tolton. According to what we can surmise from research, this is probably the first mass that has been offered for Martha Jane Chisley Tolton since her funeral mass here in Chicago back in 1911. This is the 110th anniversary of her passing, and we pay tribute to her simply because without her courage, her stamina, and her foresight, her determination, we would never have learned of her son. It is documented that Father Tolton visited this church twice over history. St. Monica at 36 and Dearborn Street was seen to be a neighbor in those days when there wasn't much in the city following the Great Chicago Fire. So on a clear day, from here you could see Father Tolton's construction of a church going on. And they took up a couple collections for his construction effort that was very helpful to the project at that time. As with all memorial masses of the dead, we recognize that the distance between them and us is very thin, and we can intercede for them and they for us. May the power and the mystery of today's sacrifice benefit not only Martha, but all those of the African American Catholic tradition for whom Father Tolton is the first link. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, and through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God of all forgiveness, grant to the soul of your servant, Martha Jane Chisley Tolton, whose anniversary we celebrate, a place of refreshment, a blessed rest, and resplendent light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and with the Holy Spirit, you are one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet it is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. let us praise the
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus answered, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. I am Dr. C. Vanessa White, Professor of Spirituality and Ministry at Catholic Theological Union, a member of the Tolton Guild, and former director of the Augustus Tolton Pastoral Ministry Program. I'm here to introduce our speaker, our reflector this morning, chaplain and Tolton graduate, Glenda R. Spearman. Ms. Spearman is currently a senior staff chaplain at Ann
and Robert H. Lurie Children's Hospital of Chicago, which was formerly Children's Memorial Hospital, where she has served since 2000. She supervises and oversees the training of a team of Ministry of Care who bring communion to the Catholic patient families at Lurie Children's. In June 2004, she graduated from Catholic Theological Union in Chicago with a Master of Divinity degree and was awarded a scholarship as a Tolton Scholar of the Augustus Tolton Pastoral Lay Formation Program. A member of St. Thomas the Apostle Church, she's integrated into ministry her 25 years of experience in the corporate, legal, and health fields. I would say she brings to ministry a genuine love of people, compassion, and a pastoral presence. We are honored to have Chaplain Spearman speak to us today on this Memorial Mass for Mother Tolton.
Good morning. Today we gather to commemorate the 110th anniversary, memorial anniversary of Mother Martha Jane Tolton, the loving and dedicated mother of the Venerable Augustus Tolton, the first recognized African-American priest of the United States. And please God that she may become soon the proud mother of Saint Augustus Tolton. By drawing on our Ghanaian West African tradition of Sankofa, we will reflect and remember Mother Martha Jane Tolton this morning. Sankofa is a symbol of an African bird whose feet and body are facing forward, but its head is turned backwards. And this symbolizes that we as a people must reach back to the lessons and the richness of our past in order to successfully move forward to our future. A woman of valor who can find for hundreds of years these words have been sung and read and continue to be so at the beginning of the Jewish blessing of women every Friday night for the Holy Jewish Sabbath or Shabbat. It happened last night in Chicago and all over the world. The Hebrew word valor is translated to mean good, capable, valiant, virtuous. The word is often used for warriors, men of valor. But in Proverbs 31, it's used for women. It refers to their strength, hardworking, a trustworthy spouse, strong at home and work. She's hardworking, an administrator. She is wise and generous to the poor. She is more precious than jewels and beyond pearls. And like those jewels, a woman of valor is forged out of adversity. A woman of valor is strength in the battlefield of life. She is described as one who is rich and faithful in her relations with God, and one who honors and loves and serves her Creator. A woman of valor is a very powerful instrument in the service of God. A woman of valor who can find. Using our Sankofa tradition, we can find and have found a woman of valor in Mother Martha Jane Tolton. And a little about her. Martha Jane Chisley was born a slave on the Manning Plantation in Kentucky. She was baptized into the Catholic faith, the faith of that family. At the age of about 16, along with several other slaves, Martha Jane was taken from her parents and her younger brother against her will as a wedding dowry for the youngest of the Manning daughters as she married Stephen Elliott. The Elliots, with their newly acquired slaves, settled in Missouri, a slave state. Years later, with permission from their prospective slave owners, Martha Jane married Peter Paul Tolton, another Catholic slave from nearby Hagar Plantation. Martha Jane Tolton bore three children, Charlie, her first, who was sickly, her second, Augustus, and then daughter, Anne. With the Civil War looming, it was valor that gave Mother Martha Jane the faith and strength to encourage her husband to escape when he wanted to join the Union Army. It was valor that gave Mother Martha Jane Tolton the idea to escape on her own with her three small children when she had not heard from her husband for over a year after his escape. It was valor that gave her the wisdom to interpret the signs of the time when her slave master died and left the plantation in debt. And when Mrs. Elliott was apprising and assessing her property, including the slaves, Martha Jane was valued at $59. Charlie, 8 years old, was valued at $100. Augustus, age seven, $25. And 20-month-old baby Anne was valued and worth $75. Mother Tolton feared that if Anne Elliott decided to sell the slaves, her family would likely be broken up and sold to different slave owners. And she knew that it was a high cost of freedom, knowing that if captured, she and her children would likely be beaten or killed, for the bounty for runaway slaves, dead or alive, was high. It was about $200, equivalent to about $6,000 in our modern day currency. But despite the imminent dangers of wildlife and bounty hunters, with unshakable valor and faith filled, Mother Martha Jane set out in the dark one night on foot with baby Anne in her arms and clutching the hands of Augustus, who was clutching Charlie's hand. They crossed 20 miles of prairie and woods and finally reached the Mississippi River. With the help of Union soldiers and a dilapidated rowboat, she was on her way across the great Mississippi to the state of Illinois for freedom and to the town of Quincy. But before they had barely left the shore of Missouri, They heard angry voices of Confederate soldiers shouting threats and curses. With valor and undaunted by the bullets that were whistling by them because they were shooting at them, she struggled because she had never rowed a boat by herself before, so she was frantically trying to steer the boat, but finally reached the shore of Illinois. And even though Mother Tolton had not had any food for several days, she garnered the strength to bring her children to safety. One by one, she helped each child from the swaying boat. Kneeling upon the ground, the woman of valor, this mother, gathered her weeping children into her arms. Her own face was streaming with tears, and she prayed in thanksgiving and said to her children, "We are free. Never, never forget the goodness of the Lord." As a woman of valor, and despite being free in Quincy, Illinois, Mother still endured brutality in the life in Quincy. Her eldest son, Charlie, died at the age of 10. She was devastated, but knew she had to endure and continue for her surviving children. She remained faithful and supportive of her son, Augustus, in his pursuit of Catholic education. She would work 10 hours a day, 6 days a week in a tobacco factory with its wretched stench and intoxicating fumes. But she endured and stayed by Augustus' side through his Catholic education, to his success to the seminary in Rome, and eventual priestly ordination. Mother Tolton had stood by the long, agonizing struggle for him to become a priest with her prayers, her support, and encouragement. Mother Tolton would eventually move to Chicago to be the sacristan for her son, Father Augustus Tolton, when racial hatred, even by his fellow clergy in Quincy, prevailed and forced them to leave Quincy. She would work side by side with her son, bringing souls to Christ and to the Catholic faith. In Chicago, Mother Tolton bore the utter, devastating heartbreak of the death of her second son when Father Augustus Tolton suddenly died in the streets of Chicago of heat stroke at the age of 43. Mother Tolton would live 14 more years after Father Augustus Tolton's death. She would remain faithful in the service of God in church. She remained a sacristan at St. Monica's, her son's mission church, until her own death. A woman of valor who can find. We have found a woman of valor in the life, the exemplary life and faith of Mother Martha Jane Tolton. She pointed her son to Christ, to God, just as another mother of valor, the Blessed Mother Mary, points us to the fidelity and sacrifice to her son. These women provide a message for all of us today. Be women of valor. Be men of valor. Be people of valor. people on the battlefield of life. Remain strong in your faith and loyal to your God. Serve and care for one another. Be valiant and virtuous. Be strong and wise, and conduct yourselves with dignity and kindness. Be hardworking and persevere in the midst of adversity. And above all, as Mother Tolton would say, give thanks and never, never forget the goodness of the Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Glenda, for those inspiring words and putting a portrait of this valiant lady we are honoring today, Martha Jean. Thank you. Let us rise and pray. Let us remember all women who worry about their children and are concerned for their futures. May they find direction and consolation in the Word of God, and in the mysteries of the Church, the resources of the Church to help their children find their futures. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the success of our cause for sainthood, for her son, Augustus, that he will continue to be a benchmark of faith, stamina, and courage for young people who are working out their tomorrows, we pray to the Lord. We pray for an end of violence in the streets of our city, our beautiful city. May those who perpetrate such hardship for others convert to the Lord and to the wisdom of Christ. We pray to the Lord. For the success of the meeting of the bishops of the country that begins today, may the Holy Spirit inspire us to present a saving word to the countless faithful of our local churches. We pray to the Lord. For those prayers and intentions that are close to the heart today, we bring to the Lord in this Eucharist, this memorial Eucharist, for a woman who lived life faithfully according to the gospel. We pray to the Lord. Take these, our prayers, O Lord, and give them your favorable hearing. In light of the grace and the favor we enjoy with you, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers and our offering be pleasing to you, O Lord, that your servant Martha Jane, for whose salvation they are offered, may gain through them the fullness of your redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For he is the author of salvation, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in our chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy,
holy,
holy, holy Lord. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Holy, holy,
holy,
holy Lord, Lord God, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he.
Blessed is he.
He who comes.
He comes.
In the name.
In the name.
Of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord.
We proclaim your death, O Lord.
And profess your resurrection.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, Pope, Blaise, our bishop, Bishop Perry, and all of the auxiliary bishops of Chicago, all the clergy and religious.
Remember your servant Martha, whom you called from this
man with him and in him. O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and kept safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said unto your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share a sign of the Lord's peace. God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Those of you who would like to join the prayers at Mount Olivet Cemetery following this Mass, we're not going to be driving, of course, like a funeral procession. If you're not familiar with how to get there, I do have some directions. I'll leave them somewhere where I can find a table, somewhere in the church here. We're probably not going to rush there, probably leaving here in about a half hour or so. If you need to use the restrooms, if you're not familiar, as you're going down the aisle, the restrooms are in the back of the church toward your right as you're going that direction. So again, we'll gather there. It'll probably take us about a half hour or so. If you're not going to take the directions, we're going to enter the cemetery and kind of merge to the right as we enter into the cemetery and just kind of pull in, let those who might be behind us have some room to pull in. And then one of the cemetery workers will lead us to the grave of Martha Tolton and her daughter. We'll have a short prayer service there. Dr. Vanessa White and I'll have a short prayer service. It looks like God is blessing us with sun at the moment. So we'll just gather there, those of you who would like. Thank you.
Many thanks for joining us for prayer this morning in honor of Martha Jane. We thank you for this commemoration and for all who had a little role in it. We've been planning it for weeks. Thank you to Tyrone Pittman and our choir, whose music was quite lovely for the morning. And all of you who have come here with many prayers and intentions, we ask you to continue to pray for the success of the cause of our son, so that his sainthood would ring loud across the world as the story of his life continues to spread. Let us stand and pray. The Lord be with you. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the soul of your servant, Martha Jane Tolton, for whom we have offered this sacrifice to your majesty, may, by the power of this holy sacrament, be cleansed of all sin and receive from your mercy the happiness of perpetual light through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you always. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.